and shake. Freak out. Have you heard about the new band, Craig? Listen to us. I'm sure you'll be amazed. Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to tonight's Greater Metro Conference Girls basketball game. We have West Allis Central against the Menomonee Falls Indians. I'm Dave Petroff, and working with me tonight is my partner, Rick Reckless. Good evening, Rick.
Good evening, Dave. How are you?
Good. How are you doing?
Again this year, new year.
Oh, it's been a great year so far.
Yes.
Just looking at some of the background information we got, it looks like this Menomonee Falls team is a very young team. I noticed on the roster that they have three freshmen up on the varsity. Right. And a host of sophomores and juniors and just a sprinkling of seniors. How does that factor in to the season in general, do you think?
Well, I think every coach will tell you, you win with experience, and the only way to get that experience is to play. The Falls graduated 5 out of the top 6 last year were seniors, and they're gone. And you miss that, so you replace it, and if there's not a big junior class or sophomore class to come up, you're gonna hurt a little bit in that experience area. This is how the freshmen get battle tested. So it's going to be interesting to watch them play and how they play together.
Well, and if my memory serves me right, of those girls that they lost to graduation, several of them are playing college basketball. And so, I mean, not only did they lose the seniors and the leadership that comes with that, but they also lost some pretty good talent and
skill
the process as well.
So every program's go through this rebuilding at time, and this is probably one of them for the Falls, but the exciting team, and we'll see how they play tonight.
Okay, here's just a couple keys to the game that we kind of gleaned off of the scouting report. The Falls are going to try to apply some pressure to the ball coming up the court, and we are going to cut away, though, I guess, first of all, to the national anthem. There we go. Stop the transition if they can. Don't settle for jump shots. They want to get into paint if they can. Make West Allis Central dribble to the left and, of course, protect the basket. So those are the things the Indians are hoping to do. And I notice the records here, Menomonee Falls 2-5 and West Allis Central 1-4. So should be a good game. And now we're going to cut away to the national anthem, I believe. And
good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Menomonee Falls High School, the home of the Indians. Tonight's Greater Metro Conference varsity matchup features a visiting West Allis Central Bulldogs and your Menomonee Falls Indians. It's also Wall of Recognition night, and we'd also like to welcome Falls Cable Access Channel 14. To honor America and our men and women in the armed forces, especially those serving overseas and away from their friends and families, especially during the holiday season, please rise, remove your hats, keep your antlers on, and please be respectful for the playing of our national anthem. Sports fans, good sportsmanship is one of the primary purposes of the high school athletic program. Our athletes recognize that judgment calls are made in good faith and they must abide by the decisions of the officials. We hope that all spectators refrain from derogatory remarks or cheers and support your athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. Thank you for your cooperation. Now let's meet the visiting West Allis Central Bulldogs, led by head coach Charles Castle, assisted by Kimberly Green and Emilio Lopez. Now the starting lineup for the Bulldogs. A 5'6 junior number 3, Becky Schwint. A 5'9 sophomore number 14, Mary Martins. A 6-foot sophomore number 20, Makaya Jones. A 5-time senior number 22, Rachel Sura. And a 5'6 freshman number 24, Nikita Conroy. Now the starting lineup for your Menomonee Falls Indians. All right, we have one starter there I goofed up on. I apologize to Tiana Turkvan, number 21. Now the starting lineup for your Menomonee Falls Indians. A 5'8 freshman, number 12, Kylie Sprecher. 5'11 senior co-captain, number 20, Aaron Otzelberger. A 5'7 freshman, number 22, Maddie Greshick. A 5'7 senior, number 34, co-captain Claire Moorfeld. And a 5'10 junior, number 40, Laura Marks. Menomonee Falls is led by head coach Craig Amundson, assisted by Brian Kurtz, Shane Cox, and Sue Johnson. Observing tonight's game is Mike Greshick.
Well, Rick,
Looking at the
starting alignments that were announced, it looks like the Falls are starting several of the young freshmen. So, going to see how they hold up on that varsity pressure, I guess.
Well, one of the keys to the game that you had was keeping them off the boards. The team we start is small and they're young, so they're going to have to concentrate on that rebounding and blocking out to limit the number of second chances mm-hmm. by West mm-hmm. Dallas, so that's going to be important.
One thing I see kind of interesting on the floor here is they have three officials, so I'm just kind of curious. I have to talk with the coach or AD Ryan Anderson at some point. I don't know if the Greater Metro has gone to three-man crews. For years, it was two-man, and I know there are a lot of discussions amongst the ADs and coaches about whether it would be a three-man crew or a two-man crew.
Right.
And
Well, it can only improve the more eyes on the game, It should help also, you'd like to think from the standpoint of the fans, but at some point you would seem that no matter how many refs you have, the games are a little difficult. But
It's always been a cost factor,
right.
You had that extra referee at times all the boys and girls games, and it adds up, but it certainly is better for the quality of the game, no doubt about
you
it.
Bet.
Not quite sure what's going on here. It seems the West Dallas Central coach is upset about something already right out of the chute. So could be an interesting game. We got people ready to go before the ball even tipped.
Exactly.
Could be fun.
Yeah. Well, again, it's going to be interesting for our fans starting a young team like this.
Okay, Central gets the tip and first possession of the game.
A shot right away from the
outside. Not afraid to shoot.
Nope.
Okay. Tried to feed the ball in on the fast break there and went off with the foot and West Dallas Central's ball again.
Number 24 for West Dallas. Conroy took that first shot, I believe, as their leading scorer. And she didn't hesitate. Falls into a man. Coach Amundson has always
traveling.
Shown that. He likes to play a man.
Okay.
It's the first turnover for them.
Number 12 appears to be the point guard bringing the ball up. Freshman, that's
Kylie Sprecher,
so she must be pretty good. She's kind of the floor captain bringing the ball up.
Get a little backdoor movement
Nice pass.
Got a high screen pick and a cut backdoor.
Well executed.
Yes. See the screen on top, and then the nice pass, took advantage of her height, long arms. Good rebounding there.
Okay, at Otzelberger, number 20, Otzelberger, number 20, she's a senior, and earlier in the season, even though it's a young season, she broke the school record for rebounds. She had Oh, God, I can't remember how many it was, but it was something like 20 rebounds in the game and broke the school record. So she's a force on the boards, and there she is taking a shot.
And we should have a pull away. It could have been a jump ball.
Yeah, there, I thought maybe they called jump ball, but they didn't.
Want to force them into the middle. You have no help on the baseline. So they are trying to force. See, there's trying to force to the right.
Kind of an off-balance shot there, but Falls pushing the ball up the court right away. Number 12, not shy. She went right down the court. Nice job. Shot. I'll tell you, for a freshman, she's showing pretty good poise early on here. Not afraid to drive.
A little bit of a block there.
Looks like she might be injured a little bit. Maybe just the wind knocked out of her.
I think that foul was on Laura Marks.
Trainer jumped out the right way. Looks like she got poked in the stomach or something, so she might have the wind knocked out of her. Hopefully that's all.
It's a nice job by Laura on that last play. Drive pulled up, turned to the outside. Everybody cleared and went probably to their men, and she had an open shot, and she hit it.
She shot at some of her fans. Saw Judge Matisse up there in the stands. A lot of our very supportive parents. Nice to see them out here tonight.
We were informed tonight, too, that Coach Amundson is going for his 200th win of his career here.
Obviously, that'd be something, huh?
Yeah, it would be.
200 wins? Wow.
Yeah.
That's about 199 more than you had, isn't that right?
Dave, I had a few down there.
Oh, that's right.
That's
right.
Only 190.
Okay.
Nice form on a free throw. Brochet Trotter shooting.
Okay, missed the second one.
Rebound.
Otzelberger there for the rebound again. Nice pass. Kylie Sprecher, she's looks pretty comfortable on the floor so far for a freshman. Kind of impressed at early stages here.
Okay. The Dallas Central seems at this point to be a little hurried on their shots.
Yeah, West Dallas Central seems to be in a hurry to put the ball up. They're not really setting up too much. It's someone getting a pass and then throwing her up there.
But you can loosely set yourself, get your feet underneath you.
Claire Moorfield there, number 34.
Nice set.
Oh, going to scramble for the ball, a white ball. Apparently off the foot of West Dallas Central, looked like.
Rebounding, like with any level of basketball, is an important factor here to get second shots and limit the other team. Nice shot. Squared herself to the hoop.
Oh, good drive into the lane there by Moorfield, trying for the rebound. Well, I don't know. Central just seems to be kind of throwing the ball up every chance they get. There doesn't seem to be a lot of rhyme or reason to this.
Ball's
shooting.
Running.
Oh, nice.
Nice shot.
That was Otzelberger with a nice layup and a bank. Uh-oh. Official's losing his pants, I guess. You gotta kind of take care of it here. I get my belt, but I'm not gonna have mine drop. So tape him up here. You had that Christmas meal yet, for God's sake. He's popping
Christmas
his pants.
Yet, for crying out loud.
He's been into the cookies already.
Yeah. I think we know one of his New Year's resolutions.
Good job, Coach.
Needed a trainer to help him out.
Oh, man. Look how ready he is.
Yeah.
A little levity here. That's okay. That's funny.
Otzelberger's our tallest starter at 5'11". So, again, we...
She's real aggressive, too.
Yep, that's a big difference from last year. We had pretty good height last year. So, again, the tip pit ball, pressuring out on the top.
Oh, ball's coming out under pressure.
That looked like a travel, but there. Nice pressure by the Falls at half court. Oh, thank you.
Laura Marks coming in for the Falls, and she also a 5'10", 4'11" grader. She's a pretty good rebounder as well.
A little cut to the basket, cut off there by Laura Marks, but off of her out of bounds. Get baseline, nowhere to go.
You gotta cut that off a little bit, but 6-3 lead for the Falls so far. Nice shot by Claire Merrifield. Nice shot, outside shot.
Her shoulder squared to the hoop and her body.
Nothing but net.
Yep, took her time. A travel there.
Okay.
A little hop step.
Unforced turnover.
That's the third turnover for West Dallas Central.
How many?
Unofficially three tonight for them already. Nice little spin move at the top.
Yep. Okay, got the call there. We're going to get the ball back in bounds. Number 30 just came in. That's Maggie Griefenkamp. Nice inbound. Very nice. Nice inbound
play.
Pass.
Little screen, a little step back, cover on the screen.
Made that one look easy, Coach.
Whoops.
Drag the foot a little bit there.
Almost.
Good arms up. Yep. I like that. Arms up. Osterberger's got to have about 5-6 rebounds already.
Into the
ball's
center.
Ball's in low. Little turner, take it.
Oh,
okay.
There's a foul.
She was determined.
Well, referees don't like block shots. Unlike the Falls on the last exchange on defense, just putting your hands up and letting her shoot. She went for the block and got her on the arm.
Yep. Good job. Laura Marks at the line. Oh,
she missed her first. Laura's shooting about 43% on the year from the line.
Nikita Connery, number 24, is the high scorer, the leading scorer for Central. She's averaging about 13 points a game.
One out of two.
Nice form, made the second one. Good follow through. 11-3 Falls.
Take them, Becky.
Catch the ball. Falls are determined to try
to. Yeah, they're not letting them inside with too much. The defense is being pretty stingy here.
We'll reach in.
I think the defense is partially causing some of those shots that Central's taking, low percentage shots. They're just not letting them get into the paint or penetrate at all. More felled out.
Jesse Barzak inbounds the ball. Kylie. There's another open shot on the baseline. Nice shot.
They're getting good looks.
Follow their shot.
Another rebound for Otzelberger. Good ball movement.
Got backside screen there. Whoops.
Oh. Whoop. Yeah, I think she got called for a foul. 24, leading scorer.
That'll be her first. Inbounded by Maggie Griefenkamp there. We got a little post up.
Yeah.
A little post.
Careful to get.
Nice size.
Let's get in there.
I think that was off of. That was off of us.
Well, Falls is really trying to get that ball down low. They want those high percentage shots and.
A late delivery on that one. Took a little longer, but it was a nice try.
Yeah. Okay. And they finally got a high percentage shot that time.
Yeah. still posting high. Flores down there. Oops. There she's
good hustle, it. Scramble on there the floor. There. Came out with it. Otzelberger stole it back again. Good exchange there.
Kylie
oh, nice. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. Was that a nice feed?
Draw the defense to you where the help is, and a nice pass. Double team, there it was, and there's the pass.
She knew where all of her helpers were.
There's a foul.
Got her, yep, got her on the hand. I think it was on Marks.
Yes. That's her second. Most of the fouls you'll find, Dave, in basketball, the experiences, it's on a, it's not on the person you're guarding. You know, you do help defense, and you come over on a situation like that, on a rebound, and you pick up a foul. Hannah Matheson coming in.
Crownover, of course, the younger sister of the Crownover, went on to play college ball this year.
Playing at Ashland College. Huh?
Yep.
She's redshirt this year.
Okay.
Tore ACL.
An injury, yeah. I was going to say.
North-South game last year. Recovering well.
Good.
Oh, there's a nice shot. Squared up to the hoop.
Whoa.
Oh, out of bounds. Line, it appeared.
Okay. They gave it to LaSalle Central. Crownover girl has some of her sister's height, looks like.
6'2", she's the tallest girl on the team.
Yep.
Always junior.
Nice to have that.
Yep, got good help. Good help to stop the play, and she traveled. Great help defense by Hannah Crownover. Stepped over, cut off the drive, and caused a turnover. Their fourth unofficially of the half.
Another turnover.
Or the quarter, I should say. Nice.
And again, some nice looks. They're just not all falling. Good hustle on the rebound there.
Nice
as a freshman. Took a nice shot. Didn't go in, but it was a nice look.
Force her into the inside.
Oh.
That's a three.
Off the glass, I think, to boot.
That's her leading scorer.
Kind of interesting this first quarter here so far. The Falls is hustling and getting rebounds and causing turnovers, but yet they only have a three-point lead. So a little closer than I think the game suggests so far.
Off
another turnover.
Off her knee, the fifth turnover of the quarter. Well, Dave, we have more shots on goal. We're just shooting, I don't know what the percentage is, but just making the shots. They have fewer shots on goal, but I think they're shooting a higher percentage, and you throw three in there.
Yep, there's right, one.
There was one.
Yeah, should have made that
nice
one.
Nice drive. And seven seconds, keep them on the outside.
Don't let her get in there.
Baseline.
Don't let her have that baseline. Oh, wow.
That'll tie it at the quarter.
Wow.
That's two for her.
Big shot at the end there. Well, Central kind of settled down as the first quarter wore on. I mean, they looked like they were taking some wild shots early on, but then they came on. They're making some shots here, and Falls is in a ball game here. Falls 2-5, WAC is 1-4, and 13-13 at the end of one.
At a point, I think the Falls would identify her as obviously the leading scorer and the one that can hurt them the most. And I don't know that you would want to offer too much help leading her. Her man should stay on her and not help out so much if she's going to be the one that's going to hurt them. But they'll adjust to her. We're getting the hustle points and the loose ball. We're keeping care of it. I only have the Falls for one turnover in that quarter, which is very good. It's just the ball isn't falling, and that's basketball. They're getting the shots. They're just not falling right now.
Yeah. I think you're exactly right. They're getting good looks, but they just haven't been able to convert some of those shots.
Right.
what they call, they took it out in the wrong place at the start of a quarter. Is that what it is?
They left the clock the way it was.
Oh, I see.
I believe it ticked down.
Okay. She wanted to take a look at it appeared, but.
Here comes that backside screen.
Yeah.
Double team there. See, the longer you dribble, that's what what happens.
Yeah.
The ball should be passed.
Okay, well, Central has the lead for the first time.
Yes. That's a turnover. That's it.
See how the young fall team responds.
Stepping into the passing lane.
We got a break there. A good hustle by 23 for West Dallas Central, but she slid out of bounds, so ball retained by the Falls.
Whoops, there's a hack.
Yeah, you got her. Yeah. She had the idea, but she got hacked pretty good there, so.
That'll be their fourth foul. Fourth foul of the half for them.
Not a lot of fouls so far.
Yeah. Emily Jacobs, I think, inbounded. Is a three.
Ooh, that looked good.
Flash.
Claire Moorfield, big three.
There we are.
Yeah, there you go. Fouled back in front again. Like to see that. Oh, nice pass,
nice
but she
pass.
Couldn't hold on to it.
That's right. Drove the lane, drew the defense to her, dished it off, just couldn't hold on to it. Nice idea. Rotate. Swing the ball. There it is.
Moorfield again. Okay.
Nice shot.
Moorfield's getting hot here. Keep feeding her the ball. 18-15 Falls.
And as we said, Dave, the more you pass and swing the ball, the defense have to shift and they don't get back quick enough. Offensive rebound.
Oh, boy, off the glass again.
Don't you have to call those when they're head on like that straight time?
18-17. Central's hanging in there.
Jacobs. They got
good rebound. Good rebound. Okay, timeout Central.
I think this is a full.
Timeout, West Dallas Central. That's their first timeout.
Okay. Might as well use them.
Fans are listening and probably hearing Mr. Wonderful Jerry Misling there in the background.
Yeah. And who's playing at the Owl tomorrow? The boys? Is that what you're saying?
I believe so.
I don't know. I couldn't quite hear the announcement.
There.
And what is that number? Number eight turnover? Or?
That's their, I haven't the seven.
Trying to get it down into the paint again. Otterberger's open momentarily
right.
Down
hand
there.
Check in the rule. Yep. Players are adjusting to that, the hand check. And there's
all on number 14.
The ball is right here. Game plan suggested to get that ball down low as they're taking that about side shot. They've been pretty successful so far. Haven't converted to as many points as they could, but they're still doing a good job.
Claire Moorfield involved in the ball. Looks like a backside screen. Yep, there it is.
That's him going baseline, coming out again. Player.
Nice feed into Hockenberger.
She'll put that
she, up. Oh, yeah. She wanted to take that shot.
Have a 3 seconds there.
Look ahead in the lane.
I didn't see there. I just didn't look at it. I counted. So I don't know what it was, but that's another turnover.
Well, tight game here. 18-17 falls. So
there's a pass on the baseline. Nice.
Oh,
play.
You got to make that though.
Oh,
another chance. There you go. 22, that's another freshman to get tracked at. So,
Eddie,
yep. Another one of the freshmen contributing right off the bat here.
Basketball, Eddie Burke.
Oh, that's on the
baseline. Oh, it's this
guy. Oh, a lot of second half points.
One got to block her out.
Travel.
Substitution, number 14.
I'll tell you, you know,
Amanda Stokely, 50 pounds, because he's different than
Brighton. Getting a number of second chance opportunities with offensive rebounds. Again, one of your keys to the game to block out.
Oh, I thought Osberg was going to take that.
We've got three, I think.
We take it. Morfell the ball again. She was shooting pretty effectively there a couple minutes ago.
Checking in for the Bulldogs, number 24, Nakita Anwar.
I was watching the screen. She just didn't get her foot out of the lane. I think Falls is using a little bit of a half court trap when they came over the line, using the half court line as obviously you know they can't go back over that. They get over there.
Pretty aggressive defense by the Bulldogs.
Okay, rebound. Yeah, that's a take. The other thing refs don't like in the coach Dave is that once the other team or opposing team has a rebound,
balls on number 23. That's her second.
Team center. First second, but get away. Nice spin move.
Let it down again. Okay, let's go to the line now.
Ball's on number 22. Rebecca, her first team
six. Nice effort.
Checking in for the Bulldogs, number 13, Megan Turner.
Got to make those free throws.
The first one was the most important one. It relaxes you and prediction make this one. Whoops.
Nice foul.
Keeson
and Morfell. Nice rebound.
Oh boy, another travel. Nice block, got the rebound, but travel there.
Nice.
Nice play.
Okay.
Top to left hand.
Boy, oh boy. It's like a battle royal in there. A lot of bodies popping out of there right on the floor.
Backside.
Yeah, ball pushing the ball up the court pretty good here. Freshman going all the way. Yeah. I love that. She wasn't going to be stopped.
Yeah, but nobody turned around. They all went to the man, and nobody's guarding her. There's that trap out on the top. Have to rotate here. Yeah.
There's a block there. Matisse will rebound again.
There's a
the freshman coming up to court. Nice pass.
Over
the
trap.
Yeah, she walked. Couldn't quite get herself under control there. Now, what is the fall doing here defensively where they're double-teaming the ball? Is that a variation of a man? Or
well, it's a trap using a half-court trap because they can't go back after the half. They actually got 3 minutes, so when you put two of our players on the ball carry out on top, plus the half-court line, you've got three against one. So see, they'll trap her in the corner. She can't go anywhere except forward. We rotate it a little bit too late, but they panic, throw the ball away, and get up to their 11th turnover this half.
Wow. That's just killing them and helping the Falls.
Yep. We just haven't been able to convert.
No, we really haven't. We should be up by more, to tell you the truth. No moisture on the floor. Get in there. Nice shot. Boy, got a nice bounce. Friendly bounce for Otzelberger. Good shot.
See, they split the double team there. That's a goal one. There's a pass. Kept her head
up. A little bit too far ahead of her. Had a good idea, though.
That's it. Replacing Schultz.
A little bit of breathing space here, but it's still a pretty close game. You watch the trap, the ball through David Dunn, depending on which side they go to.
There it is, the two. They get the split, and there's
another steal.
Another turnover. Now, then we give it right back to him. That's our fifth. You put a good athlete in the back, and those are the types of passes that you want. The longer the ball has to travel, the more of an opportunity the defense has a chance to steal. Here's the double team. Got by Claire there.
Good shot. Can't make it, though.
Tipped.
All ball. Mathiesen pulled on another rebound. Mathiesen doing a pretty good job under the boards there.
Yep. There's a nice shot.
Claire. Morfeld took the shot.
What a ball.
Go slow there on the jump ball, but finally called it. Possession left Allis Central. Arrow shows you who gets the ball on the jump ball.
Replacing Morfeld.
Again, do you see how they're set up and ready for the trap? Depending on which side they go, Aaron will go to the side and be double teamed on the wing. There it is. And what you want to do is put your foot on that sideline. Forcing the person
no place to go.
No place to go, but she slid.
What's kind of interesting is a part of Coach Robinson's game plan to force them to the left. And all that trapping seems to be essentially going to the right where they want to go. And the Falls are saying, you're not going to come this way.
The way to beat that trap is to either shoot like that or pass the ball.
Jump ball should be Falls possession this time.
Nice hustle play by Maddie. Got a minute and a half left. Oh, there's a nice play.
Yes.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Good passing.
Good work.
Yep. Nice passing. Kylie's Freckler is a freshman. She's a quarterback of the team. She's handling herself very well.
Yep.
Threw the defense to her, dropped the pass off to Aaron, and she dropped the pass off to Hannah Mathiesen for the two. See, there's a press.
It's happening again.
Force
them left, and there they go. Good hustle.
There it is. That's the piece
in there getting a jump ball.
And I think that'll stay here.
You got the wow, they're showing with South Central.
That's what I mean. They'll stay here. That's South Central.
I'll tell you, the piece is getting a lot of loose balls under there. She's doing a nice job rebounding.
There's another steal. Whoops.
Oh, get it out of there.
It up.
Now we're going to get a jump ball again, it looks like.
But we'll get it. It's our turn.
Possession Falls.
Open 111.
Yeah, Matisse's been in there quite a while, and she's doing a pretty decent job under the boards.
Looks like they're going to play for the last shot here. Oh, she had to pivot some of the things. Jump ball, that was a quick whistle.
Yeah, that was very quick.
I think four of the last possession team here has been a jump ball. Possession with Ellis Central.
That one looked a little bit quick, but it is what it is. Possession with Ellis Central.
Oops.
Didn't put the foot on the line like you said.
Exactly. There's the travel, put the ball down.
Another turnover, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Tough to win too many games with those many turnovers.
On the baseline! On the baseline!
For the last. Nice drive. Nice drive.
Oh, too bad didn't go in.
Oh, a foul ball. We have 3 seconds. Can probably make him pass
don't
foul.
Don't foul him.
Pass in front and make him dribble it.
Oh, there's a long one.
That's what happens. Nice play, get a shot.
Nice shot. Oh, boy. Went off about 3 seconds there.
And that's the end of the first half.
Well, the end of the first half is the fall 26 and the best of 7-1.
What are your impressions of the half?
I've got to say, I'm most impressed so far with this Kylie Sprecher, this freshman point guard.
Yes.
Boy, she's coming down there. She's running the show. She's that quarterback he wants on a basketball game. It's not a big drive ball. She passes for a long time. She's aggressive. She's doing an awful good job, especially for his young
man. But this year's guest team members are Maddie Hines and Mike Bieler.
Well, I think we're going to cut away now. We're going to have the dance team doing their Christmas routine. Let's take a moment and watch the spirits of the dance.
Varsity Dance Team. One of the exciting things that happens every year and definitely rewarding is the Wall of Recognition inductees It's a difficult process. Our selection committee does an excellent job. At this time, we'd like to welcome our inductees, if they would step out here, starting with Terry Ziegler. Terry Ziegler, class of 1975. Terry is currently serving his 12th year in the Grafton Board of Education and has been president the last 4 years. He's also involved in Starting Point of Ozaukee County and an advisory council member. He's a member of the Wisconsin Chiropractic Association, the Chiropractic Society of Wisconsin, and the Christian Chiropractic Association. He also does consulting for ChiroCare of Wisconsin and is a member of two committees in that organization. His past accomplishments include Outstanding Citizen Award, Ozaukee County 2001, Cedarburg Athletic Booster Club Board Member from 84 to 87, Grafton Community Activities Commission Member from 1985 to 1987, and a middle school girls basketball coach. Other professional accomplishments include Advanced Certification in Nutrition Consulting, the Spine Research Institute of San Diego Whiplash, and Manipulative Techniques. At his church, Terry is a deacon and a high school Sunday school teacher. Let's have a nice hand for Terry Ziegler, class of 1975. Next, we'd like to welcome Marlene Dur-Dollinger, class of 1951. Marlene was very active in band and served as a majorette and a cheerleader at Menomonee Falls High School. She has been part of the volunteer group at Community Memorial Hospital for many years, and during this time she chaired the canning committee for Cheery Cherry Fair. She has been a Sussex Lioness member for over 40 years and served as chair of SOT, Supporting Our Troops Committee. This committee is actively involved in writing letters, packing boxes of donations, obtaining the community of food and personal items for the troops. Over the course of 9 years as chair of the organization, she was able to oversee sending over 1,800 packages to our troops. This was one of the first organizations in the community to do this for our troops. As owner of Quilted Bear, along with her husband John, he established the Quilted Bear Scholarship to further the education of high school students from both Menomonee Falls and Germantown. She's also been an active member in her local church and civic organizations. Marlene was married to John, deceased, for 47 years, and is currently married to Jerry Dur, a 1950 graduate of Menomonee Falls High School. Please once again welcome Marlene Dur-Dollinger, class of 1951. Next, we'd like to welcome John Macy, class of 1973. John was born and raised in Menomonee Falls and has lived his entire life in Waukesha County. John completed his undergraduate studies at Carroll College, graduating cum laude with a Bachelor of Arts degree, majoring in English and Political Science. He received his Juris Doctorate degree from Marquette University. He is licensed to practice in the state of Wisconsin, as well as Eastern and Western U.S. Districts of Wisconsin, the United States Court of Appeals for the Armed Forces, and United States Supreme Court. He's been an active member of the Waukesha County Bar Association, the State Bar of Wisconsin, and the American Bar Association, where he has held numerous leadership positions for over 30 years. He served for many years in the Carroll College Alumni Council and the Alumni Association Executive Committee. He served on the Board of Directors of the Waukesha County Community Foundation for over 10 years. After serving 22 years on the Republican Party for Waukesha County Executive Committee, he was elected County Chair in 2013. John serves as a bank director for Citizens Bank of McGuanagall. John also belongs to other community organizations and donates numerous hours of community service. He's received many honors and awards for his efforts. John is a shareholder and president managing partner for the law firm of Arntz, Moulter, Macy, Riffle, and Larson, located in Waukesha, representing over 50 municipal entities. John owns and maintains the historic Waldheim Park in the village of Oconomowoc Lake, where he resides with his wife, Sandy Brand, and their dogs. Let's have a nice hand for John Macy, class of 1973. And last, but certainly not least, Carrie Severson, class of 1996. Carrie Severson is a self-empowerment guru. Her specialty is empowering supergirls of all ages. She is founder of Severson Sisters, a nonprofit organization that plays a role in the lives of Supergirls to help them become confident superwomen who will lead their communities. Carrie was always involved in creative outlets. She danced at Nancy Diane's Studio of Dance, was on a Menomonee Falls High School dance squad, and the marching band. In her spare time, she taught dance at Nancy Diane's and the YMCA. After graduation, she attended UW Stout and Arizona State University to study journalism. While at ASU, she continued to explore her creative side while working for the student newspaper, the State Press. She turned her love of dance into a love of words. Carrie stayed in Arizona after college and worked in the journalism field for several newspapers and magazines. She freelanced for Arizona news outlets Republic, the Phoenix Magazine, Scottsdale Times, and East Valley Tribune. She launched Severson Sisters in January 2011 in Phoenix. Its mission is to inspire girls and women through its creative and supportive program called the Supergirl Program. This program gives girls self-esteem enhancing tools, tips on how to develop and maintain healthy relationships with their peers, and action plans on how to handle bullying situations in life that match their personality. Girls learn how to nurture powerful and healthy relationships. This is how Severson Sisters believes they will decrease bullying by enhancing Supergirls. Since launching Severson Sisters, Carrie has been featured in Glamour magazine and was honored as Young Nonprofit Professional of the Year by the Young Nonprofit Professional Network Phoenix chapter. She was also included in the 2013 Top 50 Power Women issue of New Made Revolution magazine and was selected by USA Network and NBC Universal as one of 2013 Characters Unite Award winners. Let's have a big hand for Carrie Severson, 1996, and all our award winners. Thank you. Thanks, everyone, for sticking around, and thank our committee for the fine job they did. Once again, tonight, activities are being filmed by Falls Cable Access Channel 14. If you don't have Falls, Channel 14 or Time Warner, you can catch it on your computer under FallsCableAccess.com. Once again, FallsCableAccess.com. That will include our highlights here at halftime.
Welcome back.
You get a chance, tune in to Falls.
Welcome back for the second half of the game, Menomonee Falls. West Dallas Central with the Falls leading by 9 at half, 26-17.
Well, I guess being biased as a Falls fan and a Falls resident, I guess I'm glad that West Dallas Central has been so generous with those turnovers, because it certainly has given the Falls a tremendous advantage. Falls was a little bit cold shooting the first part of the game, and they seemed to settle down just before half, but those turnovers were very instrumental in them getting their 26-17 lead.
And you were thinking it'd be the other way around with us having the younger team, and especially with Kylie Sprecher at our point guard, that we would have more of the turnovers. Their guards are juniors, and we're holding our own here, and we're taking care of the ball, and that's, I believe, the difference in the ball game.
Well, as I said before, the half ended, or just as the half ended, I'm really impressed with this Kylie Sprecher, and I would certainly, like you, would have expected more turnovers from a young freshman like that, and maybe a little less composure, but boy, she looks like she's the real deal. I mean, I'm excited to see what she's gonna be like for 4 years. She handled herself very, very well on the court. She plays more like a seasoned player than she does a ninth grader.
Well, here are the standings of the league right now with DSHA, the preseason conference favorite. Doing well, they're undefeated, as is with Sussex Hamilton, although they did lose Lindsay Matt to moving to Michigan.
But, yeah, that really hurt.
Yep, but there's the Falls, right, just 500 right now. It's early, and but it's right there. It's painting out the top three, yeah. I think, the preseason were DSHA, Hamilton, and Brook Central.
Well, Divine Savior has the all-world girl who... getting offers from everybody and anybody. I'm not quite sure where she's committed to, but she's got offers from just about everybody, and she's having a great year to boot. So I'd be real surprised if Divine Savior doesn't win the whole thing. There's Mr. Kennedy, of course, talking with one of our assistant volleyball coaches, Miss Reckless. No longer Reckless, recently married. I correct myself. Wold, I believe it is, correct?
That's right.
And yeah. Mr. Kenny, longtime business manager here in the Falls, kind of a legend onto his own right. So, all
he's
here
a big
support.
Supporter. He's yep. a big supporter.
Oh, he comes to all of the girls, volleyball, basketball, softball. He's like an institution as far as following the girls' teams and so forth. So, statement. Well, here we go. Falls going to inbound the ball to start the second half, and let's see if they can get a bigger cushion here with that lead.
And
they're going right back to trying to get that ball down low. I like that.
It's a little double high post. There's a
nice pass.
To the heart of the defense.
Was that pretty? Just like you draw that one up, Coach.
Laura Marks. Nice play.
Okay, turnover right away here.
First turnover.
Kaylee moving the ball up. Dishes it off. Beautiful.
They're going to call timeout.
Beautiful.
By the way.
Yeah, that's they're not going
to
waste any time.
That's not
they're not going to waste any time. That was two nice plays by the Falls right off the bat. Look at the freshman dish the ball off here.
She keeps her head up, draws the defense to her, and then at the right time gets rid of it.
Very nice.
I always, when we coach, we always tell our kids to keep the head up because the game is played down the floor.
Yeah.
And Kylie sure is showing that tonight. She keeps her head up, dribbles, and looks down the floor, and you can get assists like that. She's doing a very good job.
I guess it's kind of seeing the floor is what it
exactly
is, what's
what
happening,
is.
And react accordingly.
Another transition basket. Get out on the run.
Osterberger's having a nice game again. She kind of does the job quietly. You know, you just don't necessarily notice her, but all of a sudden you look at the stats, you find out she has all these rebounds. And
I think she does what they need her to do. So rebound, she plays defense, picks up the loose ball. She's a hustle player, and she can score.
Good defense. Mark's working. Yep. The girls getting their arms up. I like to see that.
Oh, and she kicked it out of bounds. So the two possessions of West Allis Central to open this third quarter
have been
turnovers.
Yeah, here we go again. Claire Morfeld inbounding the ball to Kaylee Sprecher.
Oh, she traveled.
She took that extra
bit of a
step.
Bounce.
Took that extra step.
It's very difficult to teach the basketball players that every possession is very, very important. Every one of them.
Yep.
There's another steal. Again, three
possessions. Here goes them. Osterberger. Oh, didn't go in, but she's going to get the shoot.
Osterberger at the line.
Again, she's shooting a little, just a little over 71% for the year. She missed her first two.
Yeah, 7-14.
That's her first team first.
Get in there.
Oh, 0 for 3 tonight.
Okay. 30-17 Falls, pulling out a little bit here, getting some breathing room. Yep, both rimmed out.
Nice follow.
Nice follow up.
Nice.
And
follow.
Looks like she's looks like that's Marks. Good hustle by Marks. What I'm noticing so far is the Falls team in general has been exhibiting very good hustle on rebounds. They're really going after the ball. I mean, whether it be Marks or whether it be Matthiessen or whether it be Osterberger, you got girls really flying to that ball when it's loose. That's nice.
Hustle plays. Very nice form shooting.
Oh.
One out of two.
But that one is going down.
Puts us up by 14.
Oh boy. Okay.
Whoops.
Turnover falls.
Oh, and a foul.
And a foul.
But I hate to repeat myself, but West Allis Central has had five possessions this quarter, and four of them have been turnovers.
Yeah.
The only one that was produced was this last one on a shooting foul.
You're not going to win too many games like that. Nikita Conroy, she's their leading scorer, number 24. And She's a ninth grader. Wow. So just as our director had on the screen, she's a freshman. So
she's again, averaging a little over 13 points a game.
Wow. Pretty smooth there with her free throws.
Number 23, Bria Brown, replacing Searle.
Unofficially, I have her for the two threes and the two free throws. 8 points. See, what she's going to learn is to floor spacing her will help out.
That's a nice
shot.
Yeah, nice shot. Good put back. Who is that, Mark?
Yep. Mark.
Whoa. Oh, boy. Over and back. Yeah, over and back.
Dare I say it? Good turnover. But that's the story of the game for us, getting more opportunities.
Yeah. Nice drive.
Runner.
Okay, she didn't make it, but I still like the shot she took.
Oh, there's a travel.
Wow. Boy, that was on force.
Was he any better coach there? Is holding the top of his head.
Yeah. So I mean, what do you do? I mean, we're starting to sound like a broken record here with these turnovers, but it is what it is.
Yeah, it's just the way we're doing.
Just killing them. Open shot. Got to take that. Uncontested. I don't know if that's a two or three. It looked like a two. She's on the line, I think.
And they gave her three.
They did. Okay. Watch this one again. I can't tell from that angle.
Yeah. Replay official in the booth will have to check that out.
Yeah.
Get back to you later. Boy, they just are having trouble passing. There's not a clean pass. There's just not a lot of clean movement with the ball.
Passed by Bria Brown. Assist from Mark.
Nice left hand. There's a jump ball.
Jump before the timeout, coach.
One of the things I would say that Kylie Sprecher should work on is dribbling to the person that she's going to pass to. The closer you make that, the more people in a small space.
She gets in trouble once in a while with the ball.
Yeah. She dribbles too close to the person she's passing. That's floor spacing. It's another turnover. Oh, nice spin.
Wow, 24 the freshman. Yeah. Still a little razzle dazzle there.
Ball still in play. A couple of players stopped playing.
Boy, it's starting to turn to a scrum here. Holy smoke.
And there's a foul.
Boy, I'm going to put my pads on here pretty quick. Holy moly.
Ball's on number 24. Nikita Conner is second. Team third.
36-21 in you.
Nice spin move. Just didn't finish.
Yeah. That would have been quite a move if she had made that.
There, that's a much better pass. That was a much bigger space.
Was that the replay or is that the same play again? Yeah. Looked like the exact same play.
Nice pass and shot.
Morfeld's having a nice night.
This shot looks really smooth. There's no way to go once you get down there. And to try to take that pass, but the quarterback going across the field, throwing it through the lane there is a very difficult pass.
Also checking in number 12, for Kate Trotter.
Now 24 defenders coming out for a big leader here. He's playing hard. I have to say this, as many turnovers as Central have had, their girls aren't afraid to hustle. They Oh, there's a very nice shot. They're batting for every ball, and so they're scrappy. You have to give them that. Spread the floor. 50 bars back there. Nice. Nice pass. Good to Kylie Sprecher. Good pass to Mossberger.
Long arms.
Yep.
You see that, Dave? Every pass is contested. Every pass has got a tip to it, and there's a foul. I think we're that's getting to these loose balls and getting in the passing lanes and recovering a lot quicker than we do.
Yeah, I think this game's kind of spread out now, and balls looks like they're taking control pretty handily.
Meter first free throw here tonight. Two in a row.
Okay, Greshick in. She's another one of the freshmen. I understand that they've got a very strong 8th grade and 7th grade class of girls coming up too, so it looks like the next several years there's going to be some pretty decent talent coming up.
The longer they play together, that makes a team. If you look at Germantown, those kids who play together, the boys do. Almost another turnover.
Yeah. Kind of a crazy game to watch for the callers. It's like bodies flying all over the place all the time. You never know who's got the ball. And
with a nice pass. Ball.
Oh, didn't go though. Nice pass, though.
They have a replay of that. You watch Laura Martin.
Ball's on number 12, Kylie Sprecher.
Keeps her hands up. Ether. Plays big in the middle.
Ready to serve on shooting team.
Block out here.
Okay, get the rebound.
Head up. Nice drive.
Good pass out. Into the corner, long shot. That's a long shot. Okay, Central getting a couple of buckets back to back here. Nice. Well, she got hacked pretty good there, but that was a nice pass inside.
Nice decision by Kyler in the middle and not to work with Block. And this is good.
Balls on number 23, Bear Brown, her third.
All the damage when you get that lap. Oh, it's not taking the ball down.
Yeah.
She brought the ball down.
Kicking right up.
She got a foul, just go up with it.
Well, haven't you kind of told me in the past that too many fives or low post players have a tendency to put that ball on the ground? A lot of bad things happen.
Well, they make themselves very much. They're playing the five and four. The guards are always down there because the defense is always rotating, bring the ball and put it right in their hands. I mean, it doesn't result in a foul, but it'd be nice to have a shot opportunity in a 3-point play. One or two free throws there. And travel again.
Oh, boy.
Got to put the ball
down. Man, a lot of these turns are even without a lot of pressure. It's just, so it's focus or what? Tennis, Jesse Barzak putting the ball up the court.
Oh, nice
drive. Didn't convert the basket. I think she got fouled there, but did a nice move.
All on number 15, Megan Turner. Her first team assist.
Right, team six foul already, so we're going to get the free throw line a lot the second half of the play. Nice shot. play. Ooh. Doesn't waste any time. Puts the ball right in the air and goes in all net. .45-26 Falls lead. Long shot. Bounces out.
Nice free throws by the other end. And
Mark
must have got 44% for the year, which he goes to. Like you say, great point.
Yeah. Osterberger out there playing tough.
He's pressuring on the right hand.
Not Osterberger, that's
I said what one of your keys was, they forced her to pick up a dribble because they stood on the right hand and it stopped the play. Mm-hmm. Almost another turnover.
Good scouting report.
See, there's all these deflections, Dave, and by the defense, the offense just can't get in a rhythm.
Yeah.
The rebound.
Yeah, there's a
foul. That's good.
And we had our hand in the middle.
Quarter mark, third. Team 4. Any substitutions? Number 14, Andrew Gates. And 32, Hennett Connell. Replacing Fox and Gruffin.
Conover and Schultz in the game. I think with the lead here, Coach Amundson should get a fourth to substitute a little bit. Kind of spots. Since his leading scorer here, Nikita's at the line, freshman, averaging what, 13 points a game at the
right. 13-4, a little over 13. Completes a 3-point play. He's 3-for-3 from the line now.
He's been pretty close to her average tonight already.
Right. Oh, nice
play. Oh, yes.
Oh, nice play.
Man, they're so well executed if they didn't make it.
Yep. Oh, and another 3-point win possibility. Yeah. Amanda Schultz.
Balls on number 14, Amanda Schultz. Her puts Steve
Edward. Completed. Boy. Kept her concentration.
What a shot that was by by Nikita, though.
She's got another 3-point play possibility.
That's it. Was put by Nikita Conroy. Pretty at the line of shooting
one. This will be her 14th point, I think. I have a 14th.
That was very heads up by Patricia. During the round, she might take a shot. She saw she was covered and she dished it off. Very nice. And that was Barzak that made the two. Not going anywhere. Good defense. Boy, Matisse stood her ground, didn't she?
Yes.
That gal wanted to kind of push in there toward the basket. Matisse said, "You're not going anywhere." I like that. Seventh or eighth ball.
Yeah,
now.
That's the seventh.
I think we're in a bonus situation here.
Balls on number 24, Nikita Conroy, her third.
And I hope we're going to be in the bonus.
That is for the Bulldogs, number 21.
Any foul for that on Nikita?
That's the
third.
Shooting on
third. Right, you can go to the scoreboard.
You just make me look like look up.
Well, I focus on the monitor right on the scoreboard.
Rebound.
Don't dribble too much here now. Don't dribble too much. You know, got away with it. Oh, they tried to shoot low. Just for one. Oh, wow. That is a nice. Well executed there.
I'd like to welcome back former basketball players,
Nice job, yeah.
Heavy shoulder, good job. Gonna tail of that quarter again, 10 turnovers that I have in officially for West Dallas Central. And then the fouls, that's a lot of stoppage of play for them.
Also gonna recognize
Maggie Greason camp number 3 coming in. Osseberger still in. Motel still in. Marsh is still in. So got one new player in there start of the fourth quarter. Central, they called it off ball fingers.
That's another thing she might want to learn is to go to the ball. The angle that she gave the inbounder wasn't very good.
Yeah.
That's a good turnover. Nice rebound.
Osseberger's rebound.
You know, she reminds me related to Katie Mace. Katie Mace used to play. She was just a monster on the boards, and Aaron's a lot like that. She just gets every rebound in there.
Well, they haven't pulled Osseberger out too much. She's played just about the whole game, it seems like. She's done a good job rebounding, of course.
She'll pick up her dribble.
There's another turnover. Okay, loose ball.
Get it.
Nice hustle by Osseberger.
Reset it, Kyle. Take your time.
Up it. There you go. Take your shot, Marcel. Boom. Boy, she's having a nice night tonight. Marcel's having a nice night tonight.
So they, Marcel Central starts this play like they did the second for the turnovers.
Up her out.
Oh, a little bit of a travel there.
Yep.
I thought
called it.
Close.
Yeah, Morfield, I don't know how many points she has, but her percentage certainly looks good. She's made most of the shots tonight that she's taken.
I think this is the biggest lead of the night for the Falls at 20 points. Look at that. Not clean.
No reason for that. That's just not taking care of the ball.
Put the second timeout for West Dallas Central. That's their third timeout. Just a reminder, tonight's game will be played by Boston Classic California. It'll be 4 o'clock at 9:30 tonight. Also, if you don't have time tonight or Channel 14, you can also get that computer on your FallsCableAssist.com. That's FallsCableAssist.com. You can collect all the extra commentary from our two broadcasters tonight on FallsCableAssist.com.
Give themselves an opportunity to move away out a little bit and face the floor.
The shot by our director there showing, sharing my lack of hair on top, I guess. Thanks, Harry.
I'm glad it was you who got the picture of, not me.
Gonna have to put a deflector up there, I guess.
Nice pass,
drive.
Nice cut.
Nice drive. Too much dribbling there. Too much dribbling.
Well, they're just not. See that? There you go. But nice out by Aaron. Nice help. There's a push off.
Ball's on number 23. Here it comes.
Aaron was there, and she pushed it.
Full timeout. Nice ball.
Nice first timeout.
Yep. Well, the Falls cruising here with a 20-point lead now, so probably see a lot of different girls getting in.
Well, if I had to do a red arbok, I think a cigar could be lit.
Yeah, light up the old cigar.
Just a reminder, if you want to catch some more basketball.
Did he actually light it or put it in the bowl?
Well, they might have moved some of these things.
That's tomorrow morning. Also, tomorrow night,
we've got some of our loyal fans up there. They all have their phones out texting.
Yes.
What are you going to do after the game? I don't know. What are you going to do after the game? There's Judge Matisse. Serves the community.
Watch the general games tomorrow at 9:30 and 11.
Daughter's having a bang up game, too. Oh, man.
Only the people knew.
Okay, here we go. Moorfield inbounding the ball.
Swing the ball. There we go. Well,
see,
that was the angle.
Not a very good pass. 20 for the freshman. Oh, she didn't make it.
There's pressure.
Okay. Riley bringing the ball up. Nice pass again. Hockenberg going to the line, but again, Kylie Sprecher, nice dish off here. She sees the floor well. She runs the floor pretty well.
Her head up.
Nice game or not, she's a nice ball player. How do you explain some of these players at such a young age being as composed as they are and as skilled as they are? Is this all youth program stuff?
Well, I think a lot of it's youth program. Again, some kids are too young to think about the pressure. They're just out there enjoying the game. If this was a regional game and it was a close game, those are the types of things. But she's handling herself very well just as the leader of the team and setting the play up. But she's used to it because it's something she's accustomed to doing. Very confident player. Oh, there's a foul.
Yeah,
foot
pass line, shooting.
It's on the foul. On the foul. Next time, we'll be in the bonus.
Back in from the end, number 52 now, Mike Eason. Replacing Brandon Jack. And number 52, Manny Gresham. Replacing Morfell.
So we're getting some new players in here for the Falls now. Give some of these other players a chance to get some game experience. Looks like Coach Amundson is going to get his 200th win. So that's quite a milestone.
Well deserved.
Did you ever see a shot clock coming into high school?
No.
You don't, huh?
Why do you think that is?
I think it's easy for the players to force them to. Unless you make it like a 60-second shot clock, then it defeats the whole purpose of it.
Yeah.
A shot clock can become too long. But I think they need to learn how to play the game and put them under the extra pressure of a shot clock. I can't see that.
Okay.
I mean, they just reinstituted in college getting the ball past the half court. Mm-hmm. They didn't have that last year, but it's an added pressure. But,
as I did indicate before the game, we are operating this season with a three-person officiating crew, and that's certainly been the case in either big games or when you get to the tournament regionals and sectionals, but pretty good event for conference. This is apparently brand new this year, where they're mandating three-person crews for all varsity games. So I guess that's a pretty good step in the right direction.
Number 23 for them. Bree Brown just found out with her fifth on the rebound.
What a varsity athlete here at Duke. Something you can all hear.
You know what I like what Craig does in these instances too.
The Menomonee holds some attention. Jesse Barnes at
the point. Try to work on things like your play and the timing of your plays.
For the loss, number 14. Very much.
The pass, the thing is five over your second, third. There's been players in and there's no leader there. And I always felt you should integrate, you know, leave a couple of your starters out there to keep the things under control. Otherwise, it turns into chaos.
Yeah.
And you don't have a leader. So I like what Craig's doing in this situation.
Hold on, substitution. Number 20, Kaden Jones. Requesting serve.
24 for both Emily Jacobs. I think this might be her first action of the night. And I think people have seen her in the lineup earlier.
Yeah, I think she was in for a while.
Was she?
Yeah.
Nice pickback. They got McKeeson again. She had a really nice game on the horse tonight.
Claus is just more active than the other.
Jesse Barzak bringing the ball up.
There's a nice
three. Okay, that's one of the assistant coach's daughters. Nice long shot.
Very nice to form. Square to the basket, get the hips and shoulders around, follow through. See, she doesn't, number 24 there doesn't even like dribbling with her right hand. Rebound.
Oh, you going to get a foul here? Not sure who this is against.
I'll go number 52, Anna Lisa. Her first game. A
Taylor Jones at the line. Shooting on the line. From
Number 10, 59-32,
4-0-4 left in the game. Bulldogs has this game under control.
Bulldogs only has 13 turnovers for the game so far.
Nice shot.
Just Dallas
Central. Busted by Millie
Miners. 28.
Good look, good shot. Isaac putting the ball up.
Substitute for West Dallas Central. Number 13, Megan Turner. Replacing Martins.
Falls a pick of 32nd, I believe.
32nd time off and on the balls. That's good.
And I'm telling the other kids down a little bit here.
As we graduate the calls, the rest of the team this week, they knocked off West Dallas Central. They're the top 2 teams in the conference. Now the 12th one in the league. 20-28. They are ranked 5th in the area and 10th in the state. Graduate the Menomonee Falls varsity wrestling team.
It used to drive me crazy as a football coach when you would make mass substitutions at the end of the game. And Craig should think that the ball snaps and come to drop the ball and really jump off five and jump to the drop.
They're trying to get a chance
to get in there.
Wait for Menomonee Falls.
Yeah, they wouldn't need to have another game experience, so it's certainly understandable. But that's how you get better.
And really, you don't have too many games like this during the course of the season.
24, leading scorer for Central, has been a little bit quiet the last couple of minutes.
Also, number 14. Manu Schultz, her second. Team 9.
Again, the reaching fouls as people are dribbling and the hand checking is.
Crowder at the lines averaging
the players that the person who stay away from the most is the dribble of the ball hander because all the refs are watching that player.
Keith is going to go in with that ball. He's put off nice. Gave it off to Barzak. Very unselfish on Matisse's part. She looked, she was going to drive, and then she saw that Barzak was wide open, and she gave it to her. Very unselfish play. Nice work.
Basket by Jesse Barzak. Balls on number
2.4.
15 million second. Barzak at the line shooting one.
Again, somebody comes to help to pick up. Got a backdoor cutter. Matisse and Fonder, and it's also possible 3-point play.
Going the line.
Okay,
Jones, her first. Just blocking out there. Too many kids turn and look at the ball. They should find the body first and block out. Mm-hmm. That's the first priority. If you're rebounding well, the ball should be able to hit the floor. You're blocking out.
Well, central ball.
I think Hannah made her first three, missed her second three.
Behind the back dribble there. She wants to shoot. Oh. There's one of those turnovers we've been talking about, the angle of the pass, Rick.
Yep.
Just the ball was kind of floating away from her, and she was moving in, the ball was moving out.
Right. Defense very well. Moved her feet, slid with her. Nice feet.
Yep. 52-35.
And his average almost 3 points a game.
Player down.
Dave LaSalle Central, believe it or not, is in this quarter, their turnovers are down to half of what they had in the second quarter. But that second quarter opened up the semi turnovers actually to lead the game change complexion real quick.
To me, it's been a strange game to watch, though. It seems like there's this frantic pace and bodies are flying all over the place, and I mean, I'm not trying to be funny. It looks more like a football game at times than it does a basketball.
I think it's choppy. Neither team can really get into a flow because of the fouls. You can't get a flow.
And then the turnovers.
And you just can't get in the flow of the game. The ball's
here we go again. Yeah. His body's flying all over the place.
Well, it's going to be a foul on 20. So she goes.
Also on number 14, Amanda Schultz, her third. Team 10. McKay Jones at the line, shooting two.
Thank you.
Down low is gone over. Oh, you got to use the backboard. That's one thing I've always, I've always been trying to preach about young girls playing basketball is you've got to learn to use that backboard. I mean, when you have that, what I call a bunny shot, the backboard's your best friend.
Right. Well, believe it or not, one of the hardest shots to make is the one where you're, you don't have the backboard on the baseline.
Yep.
Right. Number 20 wasn't even expecting the pass. Luckily, you hit one of our players.
1:45 left in the game. Good put back, 52. Decent kind of rebound again. Yeah. These officials are going to be tired at the end of this game. With 24 going down. They're cutting her off pretty good there, though, aren't they? Yeah. Trying to do a little bit too much yourself, I think. Good player, but you're trying to do too much.
Yeah.
Yeah. She dribbled all over the place and dribbled all over. She's looking for an opening. And
the Falls did really well. They had 7 turnovers in the first half, and they've got 8 this half. So they've taken care of the ball pretty well, I think. There's a nice shot. They squared up nice move.
Under a minute left to play. Drive by 24. Spin around. Pass the three-pointer. And it's probably charged. Well, I think they called 12 for a foul of some sort.
Foul on number 24.
Who did they foul it on?
Well, they called it on. It was an offensive foul on 24.
It was.
Yeah,
she ran into her pretty good there. She got herself planted.
Unlike college, they have that
little semicircle
area that I was going to comment is at the area, but they don't have that.
Well, I think.
Go ahead, Rick. Go ahead. No, go ahead.
I think the fat lady's getting ready to sing.
I think the turnovers. I think sometimes the defensive control someone makes those turnovers. Not always run force, but I get a compliment for the Falls defense. Active, hands up, tipping a lot of passes.
Yeah.
Never let West Allis Central get into any type of rhythm at all.
Well, I think you're absolutely right. I think, we were talking about the turnovers, and while there have been some on-force turnovers, I think the Falls defense is responsible for quite a few of those turnovers.
Right, so.
And they were very active, very aggressive on defense tonight, I thought.
And I give a lot of credit to the freshman, Kylie Sprecher, for handling and settling the team.
Yep.
And in a game like this, it could have been sloppy both ways, and she kept the team.
Didn't let her get away with it. Right? Didn't let it get away.
There's another turnover.
All the travel. We've got a couple of those in the second half.
Final 10 seconds here.
Well, as the clock ticks down here, it's going to be a Menomonee Falls victory, which is going to move Menomonee Falls, I believe, to 3-5. And final score is Falls
62.
Congratulations to you.
There you go.
They did a nice job of prepping your team today. And their game plan has come out well and executed it. And I want to thank Harry and Falls Cable Access for doing this and allowing me to be here with you. It's always a pleasure to be here.
Well, it was a lot of fun, and it was a crazy game to watch.
The 200th varsity basketball victory of his coaching career.
So,
reaching this milestone,
he even realized it for throwing the game ball, which is very nice. Athletic actor Ryan Anderson presenting Coach Amundson with the game ball. So, that's one you've got to put in your trophy case. So, he's been coached for a long time, and he looks a little kind of bedazzled there, like he's not quite sure what to say or do. So more power to him.
You bet.
But yeah, interesting game to watch, kind of crazy at times, but a lot of turnovers, but the ball did an outstanding job. I have to say I was very impressed with the play of the freshmen, our rebounding, the whole team, Matisson and Otzelberger and the whole crew did an outstanding job of rebounding. So it was a nice win for the girls tonight.
And they didn't play down to the level of, and I don't mean this derogatorily, but when there's a lot of turnovers and there's a choppy game, they just didn't play down. But there's the crew.
There's our crew. I would like to thank Don Gordon, Mike Carl, and, of course, the maestro himself, Harry Stetzel, who always does a good job. And
there they are.
We want to wish everybody, Cable Access Network wants to wish everybody a happy holiday season. We've got some crazy weather coming up, so everybody please drive careful over the holidays. And Rick, as always, it's a pleasure working with you.
Dave. Appreciate
okay.
it.
Take care, buddy.
Have a good day.
And a good night to everybody, and have a good evening.